have assisted with documentation of interviews, and sometimes with the programs on cable TV, we show several clips and things, either what we want or what they want. And also we have this magazine.
You sent me some stuff in the mail to me.
Yes.
Where to show you films. I have no idea. I don't even know what to show you.
Okay.
I mean, it's easier to show you other news than it's just this.
But I did show in this small place, you know, generator.
Okay, yeah, that's right.
And the street for George, I have a copy, and now I get the press in New York.
Where's
the hall?
I care only from time to time. I care from time to time to show the film.
Yeah.
When it disappears, when it comes.
Yeah. I mean,
this is
when it looks like a vacation.
I'll push, we'll call him Walker.
It doesn't matter with some sound.
Please go ahead, the paper's
right. Oh, great. Here you go. Do it.
When did you do your first movie? What was that?
Can you hear?
I can hear.
Yeah?
Can you hear?
Could you repeat the question, please?
Do you want me to speak louder?
Yeah.
When did you do your first
Malga?
What was about?
Is he talking to you?
Yeah.
When we start, you look here.
Yeah.
It's like an interaction picture.
Okay.
Which camera's which? Which camera's who?
Who?
Both of us look there, or her?
When did you do your first movie and what was it about?
It was 1984. It was called Goodbye 42nd Street. It was about 42nd Street in New York. Just a little 7-minute documentary of the stuff that happens on 42nd Street, and it ends with a guy killing himself. And then that guy killed himself afterwards.
Yeah.
Just recently, actually. The guy who was in it.
Oh, you mean for true?
For real. Yeah, but I mean in the movie he didn't, but he just killed himself.
Yes. We
haven't
started yet.
Oh, good.
You haven't said you started?
No, not yet.
Okay.
But we haven't stopped you there, the real.
Okay.
I thought it was very good
rehearsal. I heard so.
I'm going to change it all now.
Okay, I'm sorry.
What happened?
It's alright.
But have some words which make us understand that it's for real. Because
the idea was that you just stop it spontaneously because
yes.
the tape is running anyhow.
It's
we didn't know that.
Okay.
Now we know.
Okay. The tape has been running for 4 minutes.
Okay, good.
Uh-huh.
The tape's been running for four minutes.
Please go ahead.
Okay,
we're rocking. Go ahead.
Yeah, we go back to the first.
What was that?
When did you do your first movie and what was it about?
I was in high school and it was about a little boy who went on a spaceship and he kills all these animals.
When was it?
That was like in 1970.
70?
Yeah.
Did you do it?
I wish you'd take off those glasses, I can't see your eyes.
Yeah, okay.
Okay.
I didn't think you might.
It's easier to tell.
What made you really create the death tree?
The title?
Yeah, the whole, both the title
the concept?
And the concept, the idea.
It's a pretty universal concept. Mm-hmm. I mean, there was Iggy Pop's song, Death Trip. Mm-hmm. That was on Raw Power. That was a big album when I was in high school. And then the fact that life is a trip to death. Simple.
Yeah.
Okay, next.
Were all movies you made going into that concept, or have you done ever some movie which was outside of that?
No, they were all... You know, you have to have a title, or if you have a group of things, you put it under one label. People can, will identify it. You know, and that's what's really important is getting categorized and identified. Nothing else is.
The movie which you made is a little boy, about the boy who was killing his animals, was in the same.
Oh, no, 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 that was just fun in high school. And then films of my friends having sex in high school. Mm-hmm. And all Super 8, you know.
Where did you choose Super 8?
Well, this is in the late 60s and early 70s. It was pretty available then. And it wasn't available. I mean, it's like antique now. It's totally dead now.
Is
Super
it?
8. Yeah, it's like it's a big pain in the ass to work with.
But
16
you're
is almost as cheap and it's a lot more accessible. You know, to get the equipment and shit.
So you think to change it? You think to change to 16? You don't.
If somebody would give me some money, I would be glad to make a movie in any format, video even, I don't care.
Yeah.
I don't.
But you get really good quality of a picture on Super 8. You get great color.
Yeah,
anybody
can.
How you do it? You do very technical?
Just a lot of lighting experimentation over the years.
how do you get this reddish colors?
Red gels.
Okay.
Yeah. There's no gels here. It's like tungsten.
And you're a director and a cameraman in your films.
Yeah, well, it's very low budget, so you have to do everything.
Oh, I don't think it's just for that reason.
Well, it's the easiest thing to do. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I mean, you save so much time if you don't have to tell...
No, exactly.
Yeah. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You don't have to tell everybody else what you're doing. I usually don't even tell the people what we're shooting. I just say, you know, you do this, you do this, you do this.
Mm-hmm. How do you work? Do you write the script or you just shoot the scenes you get on?
Sometimes, just, you know, draw some little pictures or write a little story out. Not a story, or just write down a line. you know, this happens, this happens, this happens, this happens. Mm. You know, and sometimes draw some pictures. And then last year, the stuff I just shot recently, I read that David Lynch said he used to like buy a stack of index cards, and this wasn't his idea either. He got it from some Russian guy. You buy a stack of index cards, and then you, when you draw out 70 index cards, when you draw out 70 pictures, you have enough to make a feature.
What's index cards? That's
these little cards, file cards. Mm-hmm. You know, you just, when you draw out 70, you have enough for a feature film.
Okay.
And that's all you need. It doesn't matter if they make any sense.
Yes. I would like to know, what was really the situation in USA in the moment when you started your movies? Did it affect you?
Could you be more specific, please?
Yeah, I can try. I always hear from people about your movies being very erotic. For me, actually, they are more political than erotic.
Yeah,
and
maybe.
I think political one becomes, or when is, when one don't just look at the world like very small, but you're affected by the situation, by the place, political situation in the place you live, all the limits, all the rules, you know what I mean?
Well, it's probably more...
At the moment you started.
It was probably more affected by the fact that it seemed to be so much going on at the time.
And what was going on?
Just all kinds of stuff. I mean, I don't know. I'm very sleepy. I have to think about this. Let me think. What was going on?
If you don't remember, we can count the presents.
What's going on now? Well, now, okay, when you're younger, everything seems more exciting. Mm-hmm. And you know, it seems like a lot is happening. Mm-hmm. If you go somewhere where you're not familiar with everything that's happening. And there was, like, the punk rock scene, there was the hardcore scene, and the death rock scene, and all that music shit, which is like, to me, it all seemed exciting at one time. But the political scene was a certain way. I mean, it was, I don't know, there was, it seems very much the scene of like who can be the biggest asshole. I mean, I don't know. Let's do another question.
Okay.
I mean, that those movies only reflect my own personal life. You know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What's your
at
personal
that time,
opinion, then, if you could describe, like, you talk about death, you talk about sex, you talk about life, what's your opinion about those three important?
On sex, death, and life, my
yeah.
opinions?
Yes.
Let's see. I'm at a loss for words. My
yeah.
opinions. Those are big, 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 giant questions. I don't feel very philosophical right now.
Okay.
I just feel tired.
Okay.
Sex, death, and life. Sex. What a thrill. You know, why isn't it like it is in the movies? Death. It's all going to happen to us sometime.
Mm-hmm.
Hopefully it'll come unexpected and it'll be the biggest thrill of all if you can actually experience it. And what was the other one? Sex, death, and life.
Life
is there, exist, be here now, etc., etc.
Yeah.
My opinions are, like, you know, like everybody else's opinions, pretty much. From where I come from, I don't know.
Where do you come from?
Well, I grew up in North Carolina, and then I moved to Philadelphia, and then I moved to New York, and then I moved to San Francisco, and I just moved all over the place, around and around and around. And then I've been living in New York off and on for some years now.
Mm-hmm.
But it's hot in here. Pretty hot in this place. We'll be done?
30 seconds from now.
Okay. We'll be done? again.
but the last thing Richard said is with, everything is with. The last matter.
Yeah. Oh, but perhaps you can just back a little bit into the last thing. Take the last question or whatever it was, the last explanation from the beginning again.
You
want some more drink?
No, I'm fine.
Six.
What happened?
He wants to go back that far. So this means rolling, huh? Are you rolling?
Yeah.
Let's go again.
Sure? It's on?
Are we on?
It's on? Are you on?
Not yet.
Uh-huh. Fainted. Yes.
Oh yeah, and then the guy said he felt really excited by the movies, but he wasn't really sure why. He couldn't, said it wasn't a sexual excitement. He never felt that way before. And I think he was just feeling chaos. And I suggested that he go out and kill someone now if he felt so good. That was last night. Mm-hmm. It was a big thrill.
For him? For you too?
No, for me it was like, go out and kill someone later, and then I leave. But apparently he had just never, I mean, you can see a big difference in Hollywood movies, just what Hollywood has brought along. I mean, when these were made, they were more shocking than they are now, just because people have been accustomed to, more.
Yes.
More is allowed, it creeps up more and more. The excitement level gets higher and higher. Next question.
Yeah, you follow the same pattern in your movies, don't you? You have to, if you go want to go forward, you have to go higher and higher with. How far you go? Is it like that?
It used to be, but it seemed like with movies. I don't know, I just wanted to fuck with people's heads, what can I say?
True.
Yes, this is true. So I figured if I raised their excitement level higher, then they would have to raise it even higher the next time.
Yeah.
And then,
So you definitely don't do the movies just for yourself. You really do it.
No, I did them because I was a show-off. Because I'm an egomaniac. Because I thought, you know, everyone should look at me. But not look at me, but, you know.
Yeah, you also act in your movies.
No, I mean, the only time I'm in my movies is my dick is in there about 5 times. Uh-huh. Every time you see a dick, it's usually my dick.
And you're very proud.
No, it's just like, that's what it's about, you know, it's masturbation. Uh-huh. So, next question.
How easy are the people to act those things you want them to do?
There's all these people that want to be in movies and they say they'll do anything.
And they want to see if... Well, actually, no. I pay them. Yeah, I pay them really well.
Do you always use only your ideas or you also use their ideas?
If someone has an idea, and they come and say, I'd like to film this. Do it.
Then you include.
Yeah. But we're talking about the past.
Yes. what response do you get in the States?
In the States? I don't know because I sell videotapes and I'm not there when they watch them.
You don't.
No. So I don't know. You know, some... Again, we're talking about the past.
What's in present?
In the past, I got kicked out of clubs for showing them, but that was 3 or 4 years ago. I don't know if the same thing would happen now. And I don't know if I'd even be, you know, I don't really want to show them that much. Mm. Yeah. Next.
What's your future plans?
What are yours?
Mine?
Yeah.
Well.
I have the same plan.
You sure?
Yeah. Do you know what your future holds?
Sure, I do.
No. Do you know what your future holds? I don't know. I have no idea.
No, but I meant future plans. What do you plan in the closest future? Should you work
to get a job.
The same way on your art? Or?
To work. Oh, wait. I really do not have specific plans, other than to pursue my photography interest.
Mm-hmm. Do you work on a new movie right now?
No. I shot some stuff, but I don't know. I don't have the money right now. Mm-hmm. I don't have the money like I used to have. I spend it.
Where do you used to get your money for making the movies? Where from?
From crimes.
From crimes? Well,
criminal activity, I used to, but I don't do that anymore.
What do you mean?
Criminal activity.
Can you be more specific?
Nah, nothing violent. Uh-huh. The usual petty bullshit. The very traditional ways in America of making money. Next question. But I don't do that anymore, so okay. That's why I don't have any money now.
I need a new pair of pants, I need some new clothes, look at these shoes, they cost $20, give me a break.
I'm broke. So, next question.
I'm not sure if I have any more questions, so I need some kind of, explode my question. Is it something more you would like to mention?
Nope. Am I being uncooperative?
No.
This is work. This is like work.
Yeah. Do you think we covered the... You... Okay, but then we stop. But when we finish?
We're done? Good.
Yeah.
Thank you.
What do you think?
Huh? It's fine. Fine. Good. Oh, done. I don't think he said anything, but that's good.